and welcome to Behind the Science, where we ask challenging questions directly to the scientists who are trying to solve today's toughest problems. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. Many times, we don't have the luxury of working with clean samples. Today, I'm in the lab with some of the dirtiest, grimiest samples that, if I put them in my LC-MS system, would just wreak havoc. I degrade columns a lot faster and get low sensitivity, which eventually leads to having to shut down the system. So after a day or two of cleaning, it's back up and running, and then I cringe on the first injection. There's gotta be a better way to at least remove some of this unwanted grime, and in the end, actually get better results with higher sensitivity. So in this episode of Behind the Science, let's see what tools may be available to help me get these samples clean, because I don't even know where to start. Hi, Jen, you're just the person I was looking for.
Hi, Jen.
I have a big challenge for you.
More dirty samples. Okay, I'll start with my usual easy method of protein precipitation. But... lab has banned me from using their instruments. They say my samples are too dirty and it takes too long to clean their instruments.
What are we gonna do?
You could do SPE. Let me show you. Solid phase extraction, or SPE, is a simple sample cleanup technique that can be very fast, extremely simple to use, and best of all, it can produce a very clean sample. Here we're showing a simple three-step protocol with Oasis Prime HLB, where you can simply load your sample, wash, and then elute. However, Jen, before you do solid phase extraction, there are a couple of important considerations. For example, here we're going to work with a positive pressure processor. Now with some sorbents, if they're not water wettable, you have to do a condition and equilibration step to get them ready. That can take a lot of extra time. And here, we're looking at a 96 well plate with a vacuum manifold. And again, the sorbent choice is really important. If you're working with a sorbent that isn't water wettable, it can start to dry out during processing, and you might get reproducibility issues with your sample. If the sorbent dries out, it's not going to work. And here we're using a 20-position vacuum manifold with some SPE cartridges. So it's important, again, to choose the right sorbent, because you can go through the entire SPE process and still wind up with a dirty sample.
So how do we overcome these challenges, Kim?
Oh, you mean this? I'll dry off, no worries.
No, what we were just talking about.
Well, let me actually talk you through some work we've been doing for the development of a new SPE sorbent Oasis Prime HLB. It's very simple and easy to use.
Great.
So the question is, does this simple protocol work? Let's take a look at the recovery and matrix effects. Here we're looking at a very diverse set of analytes, and you can see that overall we had very high recoveries and very minimal matrix effects with just this simple, fast three-step protocol.
So SPE can clean up samples rather efficiently and simply as long as you choose the correct sorbents and processing methods for my samples, right?
Right.
Great, let me get started on this so I can finish my work and get back on the MS.
Wait, don't go anywhere. You might need this.
Wow, so much cleaner. I knew I had a problem and needed some sort of cleanup solution for my samples, but honestly avoided SPE for the longest time because I thought it would be way too complicated to develop and optimize a method. Looking at Oasis Prime HLB, I now have a simple starting point that's not intimidating. The added bonus is that instrument downtime will be less, and I will be getting more out of my columns. Plus, my MS colleagues will let me back near their instruments. Win-win. Check out the links below to learn more about SPE, featuring how-to videos, as well as a great method development reference. and join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science.